Hey guys, it's Danny. Today we have an unplanned video. I came into my grow room to film a particular subject and I'm gonna film something else today because I just put a finger on this Lechuza pot and I was shooketh. This is wet. Like the top of the medium is absolutely wet. I hope you can actually see through the camera. This is a wet bead of LECA. How is this even possible? I placed this orchid in the system about 4 days ago. I still have water in the reservoir. And for 4 days, this pot is absolutely wet. Well, some pieces of LECA are not necessarily super wet. You can see this one has a drier top, but underneath it is wet. How can this be? This was not supposed to happen. Well, it is actually my mistake because I didn't really expect some things to happen. So we're gonna talk about why I think this actually works today, and then we're actually gonna DIY something of the sorts. Yes, you know me, I'm not good at DIYs, but I think this one will be okay. It doesn't imply a lot of crafting, so I don't need talent. Now, for those of you who are new to my channel and you don't know what I'm talking about, check the description down below and you will learn what this particular pot is. This is the pre-made version of what we're gonna try to DIY today. It is a self-watering pot that contains a wick and a reservoir. The medium I'm using is LECA. This is very used in hydroponics and semi-hydroponics, and almost my entire collection of orchids is potted in semi-hydroponics. This was just an experiment with a self-watering pot to see if it's even possible to use something like this with LECA. And it would seem it is. So if you're wondering why I'm so incredibly surprised by this, well, let me show you. So as I was saying, almost all of my orchids are potted in LECA and I'm using a system called semi-hydroponics, which has a reservoir instead of drainage holes at the bottom. We have a solid bottom, a reservoir here, and that maintains water at the bottom for longer periods of time. LECA wicks that water, delivers it to the roots, and pretty much the orchids stay hydrated a little bit longer than if I would use other types of media, such as bark. They also benefit from a lot of air because LECA is round and it traps air pockets, and I run the setup successfully in a very warm climate. One of the issues that I have in my climate and in my grow space, which does run an AC during summertime and even wintertime when it's pretty cold, and also runs fans whenever I don't film to move the air around. All of these things combined make for pretty dry top layers. And to try to balance this issue that I have in my environment, I'm not using tall pots like semi-hydroponics usually uses. I do use pretty tall reservoirs. If you've ever seen a semi-hydroponic system, you might have noticed that my pots look like they have a little bit too much of a reservoir. It's just an adaptation for my climate, and still I need to water these orchids every 5 days right now in the summer. In the winter, less than this, but I still get the dry top and pretty much the water I use, even though more economical than ever, I'm thinking it can be improved. So because I am experimenting this with all of my collection, I always thought that a self-watering pot with a wick will not do much, because if a reservoir cannot really put up with the amount of ventilation, heat and wind and everything in my grow room, a little wick, I'm not sure if it's gonna do something. But one viewer insisted that it actually works. So I thought, you know what, maybe I'm wrong. Let's just give it a go, let's just try. But of course I was very, very skeptical. So behold, today, shooketh was I when I put my finger on top of that medium and it's wet. And these guys, which were, I'm not exaggerating, I think I watered these guys 3 days ago. They have small pots and they dry up very, very fast. These ones are dry, but that one is wet. And so I thought about it and I discovered some faults in my thinking. Let me explain. So yes, indeed, we do have a reservoir. And yes, we do have quite a big reservoir, but this reservoir is not full of water, it's full of LECA. Now, if you watched one of my previous videos, I told you about sphere packing. No matter what, when you're dealing with hard spheres, which cannot be compacted, you will always have a predefinite percentage of air pockets or space in between them, provided the spheres are of same size or similar sizes. So because my LECA is not of exactly the same size, I predict I have around 30% to 40% empty spaces in between the LECA. Now these empty spaces can get filled with water, but in this reservoir I only have 30% to 40% water, if you think about it, because I cannot really displace the LECA, can I? So this reservoir suddenly becomes less than half. It can actually become a third of it being water. So let's think about what a third of this might mean. I know that I cannot show you a 3D space rendition of the place, but imagine something like this occupied with water, pretty much a water cap, I think. This is the total amount of water this reservoir can store because of the LECA. Now, this might be enough, and it is actually enough for a few days. But if you want to go a week or 10 days in the middle of summer without having to water, oh, the reservoir must be bigger than this. And this is what I did not think of, the reservoir being not only water, but more LECA than actually water. In the Lechuza, on the other hand, do I have a cup worth of water here? No. I have a mug full of water available to my plant here. So of course, the system is wet. There is another thing that actually helps this system, and in my previous attempt at a water wicking reservoir, I didn't account for it. The surface of the wick. So if you remember in my presentation video, I showed you that the Lechuza pots have a wick, but the wick is placed in such a manner that it totally traverses the bottom of the pot. So theoretically, we have a string placed in a diagonal on the entire bottom of the pot, which stays wet and delivers that water. So it's not just a little thread like they do with soil. I'm thinking this surface, which stays moist, actually helps in maintaining the LECA in contact with water more. Therefore, it is a thing to absolutely keep in mind. And of course, the third thing of all, this is an, it's not airtight, but it's almost airtight system. And that is really not correct. Maybe I should say evaporation tight. Whatever water evaporates from this reservoir cannot go anywhere else because the lip of the actual pot stays on its mask. Therefore, the water cannot escape through any spaces around the rim. The vapor simply goes inside the LECA, it evaporates inside the LECA because this is the only way out for the water to actually evaporate. So I'm thinking this might help as well. And the last possibility, as I was telling you last time, I actually soaked the LECA very well before attempting this. I was saying to help a little bit the system, and usually because my pots absolutely go dry in between waterings, at least the top layer, I never actually pre-soak LECA before using it, simply because it's gonna dry out anyway and it's going to be resetted. It's something that I got adjusted to, but maybe it did actually help that I soaked the LECA. Which would be sad, because I would much rather prefer the system work than actually being the LECA, which was soaked and therefore more wet. But I tend to believe that the water is actually wicked from this reservoir. 4 days in my climate being this wet is impossible. Even if water was already present in LECA, it's simply impossible. Things evaporate within a second in my grow space at the moment. So this water is indeed coming from the reservoir, which is unexpected, I have to say. Therefore, I thought, why don't I DIY something today and put this again to the test, but with a bigger pot this time. Now, I want to DIY this versus buying another Lechuza pot, simply because Lechuza is expensive. It's pretty and it has this water gauge, which is very useful, but not everybody needs that, and not everybody is okay with spending £20 or something on a bigger Lechuza pot. And just for the sake of an experiment, I don't want to spend that amount of money either when I can easily DIY it. So, how I'm going to do this, and mind you, this is not an original idea by far. I remember I saw this somewhere on the internet. They were using net pots instead of my clear plastic pots, and instead of my white pot, they were using a transparent pot. I think you can buy the system. I am missing the name. If I can find it, I'll link it down below to it. And I'm pretty sure I did see people doing something similar. So yeah, if you want even more ideas, check the internet. I'm sure you'll find something. But I have white pots at my disposal, and this is one that I couldn't really use because it had a shallower reservoir. It is a tall pot, and I don't do good with tall pots, so this is something I'm not using at the moment. And I have here a standard cone pot, which is transparent. It has ventilation holes because I use this 5 years ago, I think. The plastic is amazing, it still holds. But what I find is that when I put it inside, it makes a perfect seal here. So whatever water I have inside needs to evaporate upwards and from the vents. Yes, I have some extra drainage here. I already have a reservoir pre-made. I decided to let them be just so we eliminate the whole evaporation thing, and because I don't have any other pot that fits. So the idea is to find a mask pot, which can be anything, a container, anything you have at your disposal, which makes a perfect fit with another pot and also leaves space for a reservoir here. And you will be able to better see this if I do this. There we have it. So in between the bottom of my clear plastic pot and the actual bottom of this pot, there's a lot of space here. I think this much space. So at least the space of the reservoir, which is what we want. The extra ventilation holes that I have in the clear plastic pot don't matter because the lip of the plastic pot make a seal with the mask. So I think I'm good. It is time to try this out with an orchid. Actually, no, it's not time to try it with an orchid. We need a wick. So the Lechuza system uses a material which is not organic. So stuff like cotton or other natural fibers, these will not work for our system because they will decompose in time. We need something synthetic. So I had something I wanted to try, but this is cotton. Something like this is not okay. But what else I have in my grow space that I never use is synthic. If you don't know what synthic is, and I'm pretty sure some of you don't, I used this a long time ago, I tried it out. I'll link it down below to the video. This is supposed to replace sphagnum moss. Does it? Maybe not so much. My problem with it is that once you use it a few times and then it dries out, you cannot re-wet it just by pouring water on it. You need to soak the entire pot. It's slightly water repellent at some point, a lot more than sphagnum moss is when it's dry, so I just cannot find any use for it except for providing wicks for my self-watering pots. And of course, this is synthetic, as the name suggests, so this will be my wick. And because it is quite fluffy, I think it's gonna be even better to provide moisture on a bigger surface. I'm going to recreate a little bit what the Lechuza pot did. I'm going to place the wick on one side of the pot, drag it through the pot, and then make it come out from the other side. And pretty much what I wanted to achieve was a bigger surface on the bottom of the pot, which would be wet. And as you can see right now, my wick is slightly long, but that's okay. Both of the strands will be inside the water reservoir. And yet again, this is something I picked up from the Lechuza system. So now that we do have our pot ready, let's get the orchid. And as it just so happens, the orchid we're gonna pot today is this Coelogyne Satana. She was in bloom. I missed it, but I filmed it today for the end of the month. Before I even thought of making this video, I came and watered this orchid. It was the first thing I did after taking a sip of coffee because this orchid drinks a lot of water and this tiny pot dries out within 2 days for her. And I suspect because I kind of slacked on watering these days, I'm having the dreaded drying of the flower spike. This is supposed to be a sequential bloomer. The flower spike was supposed to grow and grow and grow and grow, but now it's not gonna do so, and I suspect it is actually the moisture. The older pseudobulb is a little wrinkly as well, although this orchid actually has roots. So I cannot keep up with watering with this orchid, and after I watered it this morning, I thought to myself, okay, the next thing I need to do is repot this orchid into a bigger pot. And right now, I do believe she's the perfect candidate for our little experiment. We are going to be reusing her medium, but also we're gonna be using LECA, which I already pre-soaked. We're going to put this medium at the bottom because it will be closer to my water source. And if this actually works, at least we're going to eliminate pre-soaking the LECA prior to this, right? So with that said, let's unpot this orchid. So because we're working with an organic medium, there is no actual need to remove it from the existing roots or to change it with fresh medium or anything of the sorts. This only belonged to her, so I don't need to sterilize it or anything. I can actually just use it. And there we have it. This orchid actually is growing, or at least is trying to grow. Oops. Oops, okay, this is alive even though it doesn't look that way. I'm actually going to leave these roots. Even though they don't look white or anything, they are actually alive. This is dead. I mean, you can clearly see this is dead, but that one was alive. I think this is a bit too much. There we have it. I'm just going to place it with the new growth towards the center of the pot. Fill this in with the LECA. And there we have it. I think this is good enough. And I don't seem to have very, very big air pockets. Now, if you're wondering if this was an unplanned video, how come I have soaked LECA? Well, sometimes it pays to be lazy. This LECA has been soaking here for the past 4 days. So there we have it. And now, of course, I'm going to place this pot in my mask, let's say, and we are going to fill the reservoir. Now, as a final idea, as you could see, these holes are not safe for furniture because the water will drain right out of the pot. But the Lechuza system has the added benefit that you can actually put it as it is on furniture, on your table, wherever, because theoretically no water needs to come out of that pot. So that's something that you can actually work with. If I see this actually works, I might go ahead and find some masks which don't have drainage holes. But the drainage holes have another added benefit. Since in our little DIY we don't have a gauge, which I guess I could DIY from some PVC pipes as well, but that's a whole different story. Let's just start with the beginning. So anyway, the drainage holes have the added benefit that you don't actually have to take the transparent pot out to see how much water you have in the reservoir, then put it back. You can actually water to your heart's desire, and water will simply come off from the drainage hole without you actually having to check the level, in lack of a gauge. So there we have it, advantages and disadvantages. For now, I'm going to let it be like this because I don't even know if this thing will work. But now that I have been proven wrong with the Lechuza, I'm actually hopeful. So I'll keep you up to date. I'm actually going to place this on a little dish like that because I'm sure it's gonna destroy my furniture. And of course, I will keep you up to date for yet another experiment. Sadly though, yeah, the Usitana will not have too many blooms. I did film this bloom. We're gonna present her in the end of the month What's in Bloom video. But yeah, this orchid is thirsty. It's one of the thirstiest orchids I have, actually. But yeah, the new growth looks okay, apart from the lack of the flowers, and I'm pretty sure that once it establishes and gets more water, she's going to be okay. But regarding the blooming, it's next year for this one, sadly. Alrighty guys, so thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know in the comment section below what other designs you guys used or DIYs. I'm pretty curious, maybe it will inspire me to improve a little bit on my design, and I'll keep you of course up to date if you're curious to see how this will go. So you know the drill, if you've enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you hated it, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe to my channel for regular orchid videos, tutorials, unexpected experiments and things of the sorts. And if you like YouTube to notify you whenever I upload a video, just turn on notifications for my channel. And with that said, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!